Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Myself Dr. M. Srujan Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Current session deals with patenting issues, case study of curcuma and neem. In order to understand current session, please go through session titled Patenting Issues of Herbal Products in my YouTube channel. Let's move on to the topic. First, we will move on to case study of curcuma. Curcuma is a botanical name for turmeric. Turmeric is a topical herb grown in East India. Turmeric powder is widely used in India as a medicine, a food ingredient, and a dye, to name a few of its uses. So, what are the applications of turmeric powder? It is used as a medicine in one way, it is used as a food ingredient, it is also used as a dye. So, coming to the pharmacological actions of turmeric, okay, when you say it is used as a medicine, definitely this turmeric will hold some pharmacological actions. So, what are all the actions where turmeric will exhibit? It is used as a blood purifier, it is used in the treatment of common cold, it is used in the treatment of topical skin infections by acting as an antiparasitic. Okay, yeah. Not only that, it is used as an essential ingredient in cooking many Indian dishes. In 1995, the United States awarded patent on turmeric to University of Mississippi Medical Center for wound healing property. So, what happened here in 1995? United States has awarded a patent for turmeric as wound healing property. For whom? It has been awarded to University of Mississippi Medical Center. They claim that turmeric has wound healing property. So, in 1995, United States awarded a patent to University of Mississippi Medical Center. Then what happened? The claimed subject matter was the use of turmeric powder and its administration, both oral as well as topical, for wound healing property. So, the patent has been awarded. It is okay with that. What this University of Mississippi Medical Center, they have claimed the patent for? They have claimed that turmeric powder and its administration. Okay. So, when you say administration, this turmeric powder on oral administration as well as topical administration, turmeric powder will produce a wound healing property. An exclusive right has been granted to sell and distribute. Then when after claiming that an exclusive right has been granted to University of Mississippi Medical Center, and they are allowed to sell and distribute this turmeric powder. The Indian Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR, had objected to the patent granted and provided document evidence of the prior art to USPTO. Then what happened? After granting the patent, and now they are ready to sell and distribute the turmeric powder. Okay. So, in the meantime, what happened? The Indian Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, that is nothing but CSIR, they have objected the patent. Okay. And after objecting, what they have done? In what way they have objected the patent? They have provided some document evidences for the prior art to USPTO. What is USPTO? United States Patent Trade Office. Okay. So, they objected the patent having a document evidence in hand. So, what is that? Let us see. Though it was a well-known fact that the use of turmeric was known in every household since ages in India, it was a Herculean task to find published information on the use of turmeric powder through oral as well as topical route for wound healing. So, everyone are well aware that turmeric is a well-known plant herb. Okay, it is used in every household since it has been coming from ages in India. Okay. And it is a Herculean task, is nothing but it is a difficult task to find published information, especially for oral as well as topical route for wound healing. Then what happened? Due to extensive researches, 32 references were located in different languages, namely Sanskrit, Urdu and Hindi. So anything to be objected, you need to have what? A documented evidence. So it was very difficult task to find the published information, especially for turmeric, that is used as oral and topical, that too confined to wound healing property. So out of lot of difficulty in finding the documented evidence, so they have got how many? 32 references, that too in different languages, namely Sanskrit, Urdu and Hindi. Therefore, the USPTO revoked the patent. So after that, what happened? After giving these 32 references regarding the turmeric as a wound healing property through oral administration as well as topical administration, what this USPTO people they have done? They have just revoked the patent. Nothing but they have cancelled the patent, stating that the claims made in the patent were obvious and anticipated, and agreeing that the use of turmeric was an old art of healing wounds. Now they have whatever evidences that have been produced, okay, and whatever claims they have given. So based upon the understanding these claims and objections, okay, they have come to a conclusion. The claims what they have provided are obvious and anticipated, okay, and based upon that, they have agreed that the use of turmeric was an old art of healing wounds. This is how the patent got revoked. This is the case study of curcuma, botanical name of turmeric. Therefore, the traditional knowledge that belonged to India was safeguarded in turmeric case. This is how your traditional knowledge, okay, that belonging to India was safeguarded. Okay, so in the previous session, so whatever topic we have dealt, patenting issues of herbal products, in that exclusively we talked about traditional knowledge digital library. Okay, it records all plants of all ages according to their medicinal applications. Through that particular TKDL database, now we are safeguarding the turmeric case. Okay, moving on to the next case study of neem. The patent for neem was first filed by W.R. Grace and the Department of Agriculture, USA, in European Patent Office. So in this case, a patent was filed for neem, and the patent was filed by whom? W.R. Grace and Department of Agriculture, which is located in USA, in European Patent Office. After that, what happened? The said patent is a method of controlling fungi on plants comprising of contacting the fungi with the neem oil formulation. So, what is the claim according to the patent, what they have filed? So, the claim is, it is a method of controlling fungi on plants comprising of contacting the fungi with a neem oil formulation. Ultimately, any plant which got affected with fungus, okay, how to treat that fungal, okay, so it can be treated by subjecting the plant to neem oil formulation. This is what they have claimed for. A legal opposition has been filed by India against the grant of patent. Again, what happened here? Now a legal opposition has been filed by India, okay, against the grant of the patent. What is the legal opposition filed, who filed and what for they have filed? Let us see. The legal opposition to this patent was lodged by New Delhi based Research Foundation for Science, Technology and Ecology. What is the first organization that filed opposition, legal opposition towards the patent? It is RFSTE. RFSTE is nothing but, it is a New Delhi based Research Foundation for Science, Technology and Ecology. Not only that, it has been filed in cooperation with International Federation of Organic Agricultural Movements. What is that? IFOAM. It is International Federation of Organic Agriculture Movements. And Magda Aylward, former Green member of the European Parliament. So, considering two organizations and a former Green member called as Magda Aylward of European Parliament, they have filed a legal opposition to this patent. Okay, so then what happened? A tree legendary to India from its roots to its spreading crown, the neem tree contains a number of potent compounds, notably a chemical found in its seeds named azadirachtin. So in that particular legal opposition, what they have documented? They have documented that neem is a tree legendary to India from its roots to its spreading crown. Okay, this neem tree contains number of potent compounds, notably it contains a chemical found in its seeds called as azadirachtin. It is used as astringents in so many fields. What is the purpose of azadirachtin? It is used as astringent in so many fields. The bark, leaves, flowers, seeds of neem tree are used to treat a variety of diseases ranging from leprosy to diabetes, skin disorders and ulcers. It is not about the discussion about seeds present in the plant, not only seed. Okay, there are some other parts of the plant like bark, leaves, flowers, okay, which are used to treat variety of diseases ranging from leprosy to diabetes, skin disorders and ulcers. Neem twigs are used as antiseptic toothbrushes since time immemorial. Okay, not only your leaves, bark, seeds of neem tree, even the neem twigs are used as antiseptic toothbrushes since time immemorial in the ancient ages. Next, what happened? The opponent submitted evidence of ancient Indian Ayurvedic text. Okay, what opponents have done? They have submitted some evidence of ancient Indian Ayurvedic text. Okay, in that what it has been described? It has been described that hydrophobic extracts of neem seeds were known and used for centuries in India. It has been already described in the Ayurvedic text. What it is about? About hydrophobic extracts of neem seeds. Okay, so what is the purpose of these hydrophobic extracts of neem seeds? They are used in curing dermatological diseases in humans. Not only that, they are also used in protecting agricultural plants from fungal infections. With this, EPO identified the lack of novelty. What is EPO? European Patent Office, where the claim, where the patent has been applied. They have identified the claim that the patenter has lack of novelty, inventing step and possibly form of relevant prior art. Then they have revoked the patent. Not only this, there are some several US patents which were recently taken out, like neem based emulsions and solutions. Not only this, there are some other patenting issues that have been happening throughout the world, like Basmati patent issue, Ayahuasca case, Colgate case, wheat naphal, etc., and yoga patent also. Okay, so in order to understand the patenting issues, in order to understand for which the patent has been granted, for which you need to go for opposition, in order to understand this, you need to go through the traditional knowledge digital library of India. Okay, in order to protect our indigenous communities, indigenous people, indigenous researchers. Okay, so this is all about patenting issues, especially case study of neem and curcumin. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.